Many people start their day with different things on their mind, like what to wear, check their social media, work, and how much money they can make. Not putting God first, and suddenly, in a moment, they will die, and the people will be troubled at midnight and pass away, and the mighty will be taken away without a hand. This is why you need the midnight prayer.
Hello, dear friend, and may the Spirit of the Living God help you. Now is midnight and 3 minutes. I would like to speak to those of you who are facing a moment of trouble. You are in trouble now. You are in trouble because you lost your job. You are in trouble because you cannot afford to provide the best to your children. You are in trouble because today, Tuesday, you have an appointment with the doctor, and the last appointment, it wasn't what you was expecting. You received a negative answer last time, and now you are afraid to receive another negative answer. I would like to speak to those of you who are in trouble. You lost your house. You are living by favor. And you reach to the point to say, why me? Or why God, he doesn't answer me anymore? Why God, he had forgot me? What's going on? What's take place? Or what I did? Before I pray for you, let us read what the word of God says here in the book of Psalm. It says here, may the Lord answer you in the day of trouble. May the name of the God of Jacob defend you. May he send you help from the sanctuary. You see, God, he promised here to answer you in a day of trouble. And we are going to have this coming Sunday, the Sunday that we call the last minute miracle. Actually, we are in this week of the last minute miracle. For those of you who want to receive from God a help, okay? If you have your bottle of water, you can hold it there in your hands. I already have mine here. Now is the moment for us to pray. Close your eyes. Our Lord and our Father, in the name of your Son Jesus. Lord, there are many Trinidadians, many Tobagonians now in trouble. In a way that this person cannot even sleep well, in a way that this person feels depressed. This gentleman who lost his son in a tragic accident. This person, Lord, that don't have peace at home at all. The marriage is one step to end. This person is one step to get divorced. This person, my Lord, don't have joy anymore. Every day for her, every day for him is the same thing. Oh my God, I pray and I ask you, help this person. Help those who are doing a health treatment. And it seems like the more that this person take tablet, medication, it seems like this person get even worse. It seems like the prescriptions have been not make any effect in this person's health, in this person's system. Oh my Lord, help this person right now. Set this person free. I call upon your name now, Lord. Deliver this person right now. Take away this spirit of fighting that have been, my Lord, taken away the peace of this mother. Her son, he always in trouble. Her daughter, she always in trouble. This person is already, my God, her son is already involved in bad company. Police is always look at her son. Oh, my Lord, set this mother free from this trouble. My Lord, I pray, consecrate this person's water. For when this person drink of this water, let this person to receive their freedom, their healing, their blessing this morning. My God, I pray on behalf of Trinidad and Tobago. There are many things taking place in our country, Lord. And I ask you for you to stop with the violence, stop with the crime, stop with the murder, stop with the injustice. My Lord, help our Prime Minister. Help the authority of this nation. Do not allow this virus to spread again. But let your hands to be upon us. Oh Lord, have a mercy upon Trinidad and Tobago. We surrender our country. We surrender the young people. Yes, we surrender the youths, the elderly, each one of them into your mighty hands. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and whoever believes, say amen. Amen. If you believe, friend, you may drink now from your water and receive your blessing. Very well, I am 100% sure that God, He is with you. Before we go, do not forget, we are in the week of the last minute miracle. What is the miracle that you are looking for? Coming today, here in our national headquarters, we are located at number 40 South Kia, just close to HDC building, right? In Port of Spain. Also in Chaguanas, in Meiaro, also in Valencia, in Rio Claro, in Arima, in Cuva, also in Tunapuna, and you also from San Fernando. My friend, we have the Universal Church near you, okay? Before we go, I want to show to you this video that's talking about the 21 days of the fasting of Daniel. Today, we are in our fifth day, today, Tuesday. And my friend, for those who have been taking this fast, it is a revival. It is a new experience that is personal, those who are doing this fast having with God. Take a look and see you tonight again in our moment of prayer. God bless you. Have a wonderful day.
Imagine being the source of joy and peace and no longer need search from side to side in search of momentary pleasure. It happens to that one who receives the Holy Spirit. Everyone who drinks of this water will thirst again. But whoever drinks of the water that I shall give him will never thirst. Indeed, the water that I shall give him will become in him a well of water springing up into eternal life. Friday, December 11th, the beginning of Daniel's fast. 21 days of sacrifice of secular information to receive the Spirit of God.